Good evening, everyone. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and this is Lumber Tycoon 2. So, yeah, we have some winners to announce. The winner of this week's thing is Christopher H. out of, what is that, Canada? I can't really see it. Anyhow, I have hidden the names and the addresses and all that, so you guys can see right there. Christopher, I will be contacting you via email, through my normal email, correspondence, blase, blase thingies. Thank you, everyone, for all your entries and everything else. There will be another drawing to go on Thursday, which I will be posting as well. Now, next to the first winner, you have not contacted me, so Nathan, I have reselected a new winner. So there's actually two winners being announced tonight. What? What is this? And it's going to be Tyler out of the USA. And it's Tyler J, and I've hidden the names and the addresses and all that stuff like normal, but you got the plus one for the sub. Thank you so much for your entry. You two will be winning the trucks and a 30-minute episode. That 30-minute episode is played with me in a recording if you want, or just offline. Depends on like what you want. You are the winner. So you tell me, and I will contact you via email or Twitter or whatever you signed up with, and we'll get together. So, absolutely. But I would love to do a video of you getting the truck and the presence and the awesomeness. Oh my gosh, I just got a frog in the throat. No! Anyhow, let's get on with the video. Those were the winners. Excellent job, you guys. Excellent job to everyone who entered. Thank you guys so much for the comments and the suggestions and everything. And also thank you to everyone who was telling me like what I had missed inside the present boxes, because I definitely did miss one of the turkeys and something else. Oh my gosh, my nose is just going crazy on me right now. So let's do this. I looked around and I'm sitting here like, my goodness, why is this area so messy? And it's because I don't have any room for the axes that I've got. I've ran out of room for like the betas, and the alphas are running out of room. So that's what we're gonna work on tonight, is expanding this area out. So I need to move this trailer straight up out the way. Excuse me. Oh my gosh, everything's flying all over the place. Lift, sir, lift. He is not a strong person. Not a strong Robloxian. Okay, so we gotta get these out of here. can we move them in the lab for the moment? Let's go ahead and move these into the lab. And make a game out of it. Woo! And woo! We'll pick these up later. We'll make it like a path or something for them to go on. That would be amazing, by the way. A huge path that like goes around the outside of the base along rails and stuff, and then like hits a track, and a whole bunch of hatches will lift them back up to their original position. Oh, that would be awesome. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm absolutely gonna do that. Come here, you silly goose. Falling out of there and stuff. So what's up, everyone? Oh gosh. You may have noticed I am in a private server, and that is because I tried for 30 minutes to jump into a public server, and almost every one of them was the plot one was taken, which is my normal plot for the gold bridge and all that stuff. Now, I can play in other plots, but this is the one that I used to go get the gold wood, and it's the one with the gold bridge, and yeah, it's my preferred one. Now, when I did find one that I could go into and claim, once I got on there, there was somebody that logged into base number two, plot number two over there, and they had a bold and brash going off. Like, bold and bold and bold, and I asked them to make it stop, and they weren't listening. I mean, they were literally, I was asking them, hey, can you turn off the bold and brash? And they were like, hey, go to your Discord. I'm like, dude, can you turn off your bold and brash? Hey, send me a friend request. Dude, can you turn off the bold and brash? I can't record until the bold and brash is off, because it's going to be going off the entire time. So, I do apologize about not playing in a public server tonight, but I gotta get you guys a recording of some kind, and that's exactly what I want to do. Okay, so the idea is I'm going to take this wall out, and we're going to expand this out double the length, so there's going to be this same kind of wall, only on the back side, like this, facing this direction, so we have like a dual set of axe shelves. The other thing is, I was thinking about doing another axe shelf right here. So this would be like a center row right here. And then we'd have the two sets of axes. And then possibly a third set back here. Anyhow, that's what I want to do. Let's see if it's going to happen. No, we don't want to destroy. I want to move. And we're just going to expand this out. Oh, my goodness. Why is that? It's not attaching correctly. All right, there it goes. Boom. Move this one. Oh, that was like a little half wall. All right, hold on. Let's get that out of the way. Move it over here like that. So basically, it's redesigning the base. And I hope it works out correctly. Because if it doesn't, like this could turn into a big mess. We don't know. All right, there's two. How many wide did I go on the first walls? Let's see here. One, wait, is that one? Oh, yeah, one, two, three, whoa, four, five, six. It looks like six, so. We're gonna have to go six out this direction. Move. And I am gonna have to go and get more gold wood to build more. Absolutely. Let's just bring this all the way up to the lab door. That way it'll be like a wall and then to the door. There we go. That'll work. And let's grab these. Okay, we're gonna have to pick these up. Because we can't attach right here. Is this one? Nope, that's a full smooth wall. So, move. And move. And then we're going to expand this one out. Let's go this direction. By the way, those of you who are asking for the private server link, I do not give it out. I do, however, allow like Dig Dug and Mummy and Blobby, and you know, they are allowed to come in anytime. All right, that looks good. Let's go ahead and move the door out. Move. We'll stick you over here with the rest like that. All right, and I haven't used these in almost a year, so we're going to go ahead and destroy those. That was part of the first wedges. Okay, let's grab all end times axes. Come on, there we go. And good. And we'll organize these. So it's organizing axe day. Whoops. That one. That is a chicken axe. There's that one. Good. Awesome. Nice. So there's all the end times axes. Just kind of get them lined up here. Whoa! Axe flip. Kind of like bottle flipping, only in lumber. And basically what I'm doing is getting them lined up so they're the same direction, which should make it go a little bit faster because I won't have to rotate everything. Actually, I'm still going to have to rotate like this. Whoa. Three-dimensional rotation. There we go. Good. And drop you down like that. Push. Good. Now grab this one. Turn, rotate. Good. Boom. Organization. Nice and organized. Judging by like the amount of axes that were out there, I'm not sure that I'm going to have to expand that much, but we also have a lot of loose axes on the base. So the idea is to get those all picked up as well. And the reason I want to move the axes is because I can pick up 9 at a time. So I can move 9 instead of having to run back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, which I realized was like, that's most of the time consumption. When you're cleaning your base or when you're picking things up or when you're loading up to sell, like if you sell a truckload of things, I know people buy truckloads of eyeballs and stuff like that. The biggest time consumer is the individual items. So, Defaultio, give us multi-pickup. Actually, I don't know how that would work, because they're all non-anchored items. So it just doesn't work quite as well. What happened here? This one, you just fall down? All right, we'll get that one back up there. Like fell right out of that little slot right there. Oh, goodness. No. Hold on. There. Good. good. That one fell down. Okay. I don't like the double stacks like that. So let's get this out of here. This is not a pumpkin shop. We need to get the pumpkin out. There we go. Anything else that is non... Okay. So that's all of these, right? Ooh, I got lots of coal. Nice. Chicken axe, fire axe. What is this? Is this just loose? Yeah, that's a loose block there. Drop that down. Good. Oh, forgot where my door was. And let's go grab... Oh, gosh. End times axes. End times. Uh-oh, that was a Ruki. Sorry, Ruki, not yet. End times. And these are going to be for loose axes only as well. So like, oh, my backpack's full. So like these boxed axes, I'm going to go ahead and get them out of here. Put the golden axe right there. I'm just kidding, it's not a golden axe. Everyone's like, what? Got you, haha, fooled you. I'm just kidding. These are basic hatchets for purchase inside the lumber or Woods R Us store. There's a silver axe boxed. And there's that. By the way, I took a wild hunch at when the beta axe was still in game, and I told Blobby, I said, Blobby, let's go buy as many beta axes as possible. Sure enough, we bought like a ton. I mean, we bought a ton. Well, it was a ton back in the day of beta axes, and we just filled his base with it and ended up like a week later, literally a week later, it was no longer available. And Blobby's like, what? And I was like, I told you, dude. I told you. All right. Floodlight. Can we move the floodlight underneath? And that doesn't work, really. What if we do turn? Nope. Turn. Like that. And then rotate. Like that. That is totally not what I wanted. All right. Rotate. Turn. Come on. Move around. Turn. Nope. It's still... Turn. There we go. Turn. Nope. Yes. That's what I want. But in that direction. Come on. Why is building so hard for me? That is still not the right direction, dude. All right, move. Okay, rotate, turn. Rotate. Yes, perfect. So that way it shines the light down in that general direction. That one we can leave where it's at. This one I wouldn't mind having the opposite direction. So we'll do rotate, rotate. And good. There we go. Some display lights. And now we can fill up this side with end times axes. 4, 5, 6, 0, 2, no, 1. There we go. And let's move the chicken axe. Actually, let's drop the chicken axe. That way we can pick up more of the other stuff. 2, drop. There we go. Okay, cool. So, drop this down. Good. Whoa. It's going crazy. It's a wild end times axe. Look out. Okay, there we go. Grab this one. Turn. Rotate. Oh, hold shift. Have to hold shift to rotate. There we are. Very well. Good. And organized. Look at this getting organized and picked up. By the way, I read your comments, and you guys, I don't know, for whatever reason, really like watching me clean my base. It just, I was completely astounded, honestly. I was like, you guys would rather see me doing this, picking up, organizing, than building or... Like, I've got to put a vote out there or something. So, look on my Twitter for a vote. Clean base or build something. I'll throw it out there on Twitter. And if you don't have Twitter, ask one of your parents to, like, go vote for you or something. Oh, gosh. And if you're a parent and you're not allowed to have Twitter, it's a different case. Oh, come on. No. Okay, I gotta look at it, don't I? There we go. Being in... Whoa! Sir. Okay. By the way, I have... in the past, I've been flung out of the axe shop. And I don't remember how, but I remember where. Oh, gosh. What was that? You see all that? It was like a slinky effect. 2.0. Effect 2.0. What's up, Effect? Has he been back in here to play anymore? Oh, gosh. I don't want to have to move all of them down. Yeah, we're going to leave that. Leave it before I mess it up. By the way, I'm still trying to get with Slick, that Slick nerd. He is a Roblox streamer. But... would love to do a collaborations of some kind. Get him in here to lumber and show him the Jedi mind tricks of levitation. Wingardium Leviosa. Harry Potter reference. Alright, I gotta pick those up to get to the ones on the bottom. Come on. Almost full. One more. There we are. Okay. Drop. 9, drop. 8. That's an alpha. Drop. Ah, that was an alpha. 4. Drop. 2 is a fire. 1. In times. There we go. Where's that alpha? Sneaky alpha. There we go. Okay. Now we can move. Organizing, picking up. Amazing awesomeness. There we go. Okay. Now to pick up this one. I will try and hit it right at the 30-minute mark. If I happen to go over, I do apologize. What tends to happen is whenever I'm cleaning, I don't pay attention to how long I've been recording. And I mean, something that was supposed to be a 30-minute episode turns into like 2 hours and 45 minutes. Just kidding. It's not that long. I won't go that long. I can't go that long. It's like way past my bedtime. Wait, Kud has a bedtime? Yes, I have to go to bed and get sleep because work comes very early in the morning for me. By the way, I'm getting more comments about like, who's this 40-year-old man playing Roblox? Go get a job, you bum! I'm like, really? Dude, have you even watched my videos? Seriously. Like, this is my fun time. This is my free time. Leave me alone. By the way, if you go and look on the Roblox creation screen, like the Roblox account creation, I think the actual age limit, you can't go past 119. So if you are over 119 years old, don't play Roblox because you can't get the, you can't make an account, okay? It won't let you. It's too far. But if you're under 119, by all means, jump in here. Let's play some lumber. All right. Turn. By the way, huge shout out to Dig Dug for his pepper challenge. That was awesome and amazing. So if you have not seen that, you need to go over to Dig Dug's channel after this. Not right now. After this. And Dig Dug, if you're watching, that was awesome. So, I think the person he challenged was Effect 2.0. So, I'm ready for his live stream. I'm going to be watching out for that. I've got a little bit of money saved up for some super chats at the completely wrong times. If you don't know what it is, any kind of notification, subscribe, stuff like that, is an automatic unload your weapon on Fortnite. And if you've ever played Fortnite, you'll know that the, come here. You'll know that by shooting any kind of weapon, you basically give away your position. And it's a dead giveaway. Like, you can tell where somebody's shooting from because of the stereo effect. If you've played Fortnite, but you haven't used headphones, you must have stereo headphones because the sound is incredible. Like, you can tell where people are walking and if they're building and all kinds of good stuff. So, amazing game. Oh, and I also asked my daughter. I told her, you're still not able to start a YouTube channel until you're 13. She's like, I know. So I asked her if it would be okay if I started the Ori series. And she said, yeah, that'd be fine. So, hopefully I will now have a new series for you guys on Xbox. Ori and the Blind Forest. And that should be dropping today. Maybe today. Maybe tomorrow. I don't know. We'll find out. We'll see what's going on. How long have we been in for? I gotta keep an eye on the time. 23 minutes! Oh my goodness! We have already gone 23 minutes? Did you guys feel... Did it feel like 23 minutes already? It never feels as long as it actually is. I don't know. For some reason, it is a different feeling whenever you're recording. Because I could sit here and play for hours. And I could probably record it for hours. But I don't think I'm going to have enough room. Oh, gosh. Drop. There we go. Just because... Axe flip. Dab. Just kidding. And it landed perfect, too. Sweet. I probably shouldn't have dropped him so close here. I need to move out here. There we go. Okay. And let's move these in. Welcome, In-Time Axe, to your new home. What was I saying? The time It is definitely a time deprivation, or not a deprivation, a time warp of some kind, because it literally feels like I've been in here for 5 minutes. It does not feel like it's been 25 minutes, but that's how it feels. And I'll warn you, if you are one of the winners, the same thing happens when we're recording. Like, whenever you guys go in and you're like, I want to play with you, I want to build, I want to do this. There's only 30 minutes, so it goes by really quick. It's incredibly quick. Coffee. It is incredibly quick on how time flies. Same thing happens to me when I'm at work and I'm programming. Like, I'll think to myself, oh, I've got 8 hours to get this this web page reprogrammed, uploaded, database entries all set. And if you guys don't know, like, what I do, I program web applications internally for a corporation that I work for. And basically, I make apps for people inside of our company. So I make tools and stuff like that. I also do crystal reports and reporting, SQL databases, creations, maintaining, backups, stuff like that. I program in Cold Fusion, C Sharp. Sorry, about said C++. I do C++, but not at work. HTML, JavaScript. I do know Java, but I don't program in work, or program at work in Java. jQuery. jQuery is fun. It adds a whole new dynamic to JavaScript. But basically, it's a different way of writing JavaScript. Oh, come on. That did not rotate correctly. There we go. And if you are interested in starting programming, I highly recommend Python, just to get started. Python still requires like a download and install and stuff like that, but it will give you a basis of how programming languages work. If your school offers you classes on computer programming, I highly recommend that you take them. Even if you're not interested in going into programming as like a career, I still highly recommend it because of the math that's involved, the logic, the troubleshooting, stuff like that. So that's 28 minutes, guys. All right, let's just take a quick walk around for any end times axes that may or may not have been flung around on the base. If you happen to see one and I don't see it, let me know. Is there an end times axe over there? Nope, there's a Ruki hidden out. Taking a walk around. We're just gonna have to clean this all up in sections, aren't we? Ugh, I don't like cleaning. I really don't like cleaning. Like, I'll clean my room and the living room and pick up and stuff, but that's because I've got kids. But when it comes to like cleaning my base, I don't want to clean my base. I clean in real life. Doesn't that count? By the way, these are all explosions from random stuff, except for those. Those are long planks. Yay. Looks like all the loose end times. Uh-oh, wait, is that one? No. It's a Ruki. Huh. Amazingly, all the end times axes fit. There's gotta be more. Ah, hidden. It's like a little treasure chest. Also, somebody gave me the idea that I should take and have a whole bunch of my presents and place them in trucks and then hide them in various areas around the map. And then what I can do is I can whitelist and blacklist everybody that comes into my private server, and say you have like 30 minutes to find the presence. So I don't know. That's an idea. It's a thought. I don't know how well that would work out, but like I could show you guys me hiding the presence beforehand and then invite the people from like Discord or something like that, and then you could come in. It's an idea. And, you know, thoughts turn into ideas, ideas turn into dreams, dreams turn into reality. No, that's completely backwards. Dreams turn into thought, a thought turns into an idea, and an idea turns into reality. Something like that. Insert motivational speech here. Thank you, everyone, for watching this winner's pick and reorganization of the axe shop. I'm not reopening up the axe shop, so I'm thinking about taking down the sign, but I mean, that was the first like build thing that I had, which was how to make the axe sign neon with glowy lights. I had it on a timer at one time, so I mean, it was flashing. I don't know why it's not now, but anyhow, that's for another time. Thank you, everyone, for watching this episode of Lumber Tycoon 2 with me, Heath Haskins, Code Primate. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. Do all those cool things I'm supposed to call out at the end of the videos, because that's what we're supposed to do, and that's what YouTube trains us to do. That's called a call to action, by the way. And it's really okay. If you don't want to sub, I don't mind. If you do, go for it. And I won't ever pressure you guys, be like, you gotta sub, you need to blah, blah, blah. It's your choice. If you want to, go for it. If not, it's okay. Love you guys anyway. Love you guys forever! Have a great night, and we'll talk to you very soon. Outro. Thank you.